Welcome back to Jersey Matters. Dawn sends Lamenti here at Princeton Battlefield State Park. What happened here January 3rd, 1777 is famously known as one of the fiercest battles of the American Revolutionary War.
General George Washington and his troops marched across frozen farm fields, surprising the British.
It's an ideal battlefield because it's open fields, farmland, not thickly wooded. There are woodlots about, but otherwise an ideal 18th century battlefield.
Ideal for General Washington to claim another victory, which was critical to keeping his job and hiking enlistments.
He had the troops for a limited amount of time. The enlistments were running out at the end of the year, and Washington was able to retain most of those soldiers for another 4 to 6 weeks. Some additional troops had come up earlier in the month out of Philadelphia to help support them, but he only had a limited amount of time to operate with them. But he's telling them they can do more for themselves, their country, their families right now if they stay on.
The soldiers remained loyal after receiving a recent and much-needed boost in morale.
They had a long retreat prior to the battles of Trenton and Princeton across New Jersey. He has a victory at Trenton a week earlier. He doesn't want to lose that momentum, the good feeling the soldiers have for themselves. So he's making an attacking motion here.
Historic paintings depict the action famously called the 10 critical days in the American Revolution. The Clark House, built by Thomas Clark in 1772, witnessed the fierce fighting and served as a triage unit where dozens of soldiers were treated. Visitors can tour the farmhouse, complete with period furnishings, as well as a museum with Revolutionary War exhibits and weapons.
What I feel is that the battles of Trenton and Princeton helped keep Washington in command. They were actively looking for a replacement for him prior to that. It keeps an American army in the field, and it makes the British realize that the war is going to have to be prosecuted in a much different manner.
Princeton Battlefield State Park draws thousands of tourists every year who come here to relive history, as well as enjoy the lush fields and forests with hikes and picnics. An outdoor highlight is the Ionic columns designed by Thomas Walter, the architect of the U.S. Capitol building. Near the columns, a stone patio marking the grave of 21 British and 15 American soldiers killed in the Battle of Princeton.
And now with this critical victory behind him, General George Washington and his army took 3 days on the march to Morristown for higher ground. Reporting for Jersey Matters, Dawn Stens Lamenti. Up next, Larry's commentary.